There was ice everywhere. The power went out. The power lines were touching the ground because the ice was, you know, so heavy.
But what exactly made this storm so much worse than other ice events? Meteorologist Josh Judge is here tonight, and he experienced the answer firsthand.
Yes, sure did. Who can forget that storm, and who can forget the loud sound of the cracking trees as they fell? If you were in this area here, these are the areas that were most affected by the ice storm. So parts of central New Hampshire and all of southern New Hampshire, as well as other parts of New England too. What a storm it was. And why did it happen just in that way with the freezing rain? Well, the temperatures were just below freezing 32, just barely, but not above. Higher up in the atmosphere, the temperatures were above freezing. So when you have rain, it's above freezing all the way down through the air, and it lands, the precipitation does, as rain. But in this case, it was above freezing in the upper parts of our atmosphere. But then the rain falls through the atmosphere, and right at ground level, it was below freezing 32. So everything on the ground was frozen. So the rain comes down and then instantly freezes. And then one drop fell on top of another, fell on top of another, and before you knew it, that ice was building up on tops of trees, bushes, everything else. And this is what it looked like, with trees down everywhere. These photographs really showing what it looked like the next morning when the sun was bright, but the temperatures were still so cold, and thousands, tens of thousands, if not more, trees fell everywhere, taking down power. And the interesting thing about this is, as the ice was building on tree branches and bushes, it increased the weight of the branches 30 times. 30 times. That's why so many trees fell.